Hello, I'm Mike, and I run a thriving community on Circle that actually has over 10,000 members. That's the problem if you're an entrepreneur, a business owner, scaling online with a large community of members. You can't always be there to answer things 24/7. But now Circle, the platform I host on, introduced AI agents. I have the ability to build multiple agents to run my community 24/7, and in this video, I'll show you how I'm doing it. First up, I wanted to highlight this excellent blog post, the difference between AI tools and agents. The tools do things when you tell them to do things, but AI agents do the work for you, even when you're not there. Another really cool thing to this AI-first approach is this summarize button in my community. I can summarize all the posts from the last month. And it's going to show me a summary of some of the questions and some of the discussions that have happened in my community recently. So now let's get into building our very first AI agent. And you'll see this very intuitive user interface where I can upload an avatar, enter a welcome message such as, I'm your AI sidekick for all things coding and creativity. A bit of a bio here, such as, I'm here to help you create absolute magic. I hope you get the pun there. And finally, I can add in some suggested questions, such as which AI coding tool should I use for my project? What's the best way to automate things with AI? And what are the latest AI tools I should know about? I've now named the agent Creator Magic Wizard, and I can choose the audience that will see my agent. My 12,000 plus community can see it, but if I want, I can add a filter by pretty much anything that's available inside my community. And then I can send everyone a welcome message so they'll get something that will slide into their DMs and the whole of my community can immediately interact with my AI agent. Next, under behavior, I'm allowed to say the agent's general purpose and I can use 1,000 characters here to describe exactly what I'm here to do, like take the mystery out of AI development. We can use AI-generated answers, but really soon, you'll also be able to add in custom answers. I've selected friendly for how my AI agent should sound. And I can even add pause words if this is a critical agent that's helping with customer service, support, error, human, and need help might be able to hand off to a human because us humans are still pretty good in some scenarios and we can easily take over from the AI agent. And then finally, it gets really exciting with knowledge. I can train in different knowledge from my community. I won't be training in things such as start here and say hello, but other things such as new AI tools, best AI tools from my AI tools directory, and discussion and AI mic can all be trained in to my agent ready to be used. But now we'll save and launch this agent, and I can go straight into my direct messages and start to have a chat with it. What can you do? And here you can see I've been answered. It can answer questions, guide projects, fetch resources, and all along the way it's using the AI context of my community to answer the question. Let's try a sample question. Which AI coding tool should I use for my project? And here not only can you see it said Cursor, GitHub Copilot, Replit, Gemini Code, and the new OpenAI Codex CLI. It's also mentioned the sources down here, and you can see different posts in my community that I can click to get more information on exactly these tools. What's the best way to automate things with AI? Again, the Creator Magic Wizard has pulled in recent stuff like Stagehand, LangChain, ChatGPT Tasks, Claude Computer Use, Puppeteer, and even the new OpenAI Agents SDK. And of course, I can use sources to dive deeper into all of that stuff. It helps me get to the stuff I need quickly, which can be quite overwhelming when there are 12,000 members having discussions. The Creator Magic Wizard now distills that and gives you exactly the info any member needs at any point. Finally, I've asked here, what are the latest AI tools I should know about? It's given me Cursor Composer, Photo AI, Ideogram, even stuff like, Kling and Manus. So in this instance, it's pulled back from my whole year worth of knowledge. It would be nice in the future to maybe add a recency score to some of that stuff, but this is an excellent general use agent that can serve my community with knowledge really quickly and much quicker than I could if I was responding to every single request. Now, I've had a space here for a while where you can ask AI Mike a question in the form of a new post, and then AI Mike will respond to your question with some YouTube knowledge and even the YouTube videos that I mentioned the stuff in. This is great, but it requires making a new post in the community and getting a response. You can't have nuanced, continual conversations. I'd like to now give AI Mike the AI agent ability to have conversations with all of my members, and I can set this up with ease now, thanks to AI agents. So let's go back to my menu here and go for AI agents, and I'm going to set up a brand new agent. For the avatar, I've got that image of AI Mike. Looks really funny, doesn't it? And we can actually rename this agent to AI Mike. for the welcome message here, I'll say I'm an AI agent and I know everything Mike has spoken about. For the bio, I'll say ask me anything about Mike's creator magic videos. Next up, I can go to audience. And again, all of my audience, those 12,000 members, will see it. And you can see here, they'll get a welcome message from AI Mike in their inbox again. I can customize this if I'd like, but the same welcome message that I typed in step one will be absolutely perfect. For the behavior, you are an AI version of Mike Russell. We'll be using AI-generated answers, and we'll keep things short and sweet for this one so AI Mike can get straight to what's needed. The most important thing is training in that knowledge. Now, I did a previous video on my channel you can check out on how I store all the transcripts from my YouTube videos in multiple different places, including Google Drive. Over here in Google Drive, you'll see I've got a spreadsheet with all my videos and a directory with all of the transcripts to all the videos I ever made. So I can download these all in one go, just preparing my download as a zip file here. Now here you'll see I'm able to upload snippets of text, but also PDF and TXT files. Now you notice here I can drag and drop up to 100 megabytes, which is fine because transcriptions are really small in size. Drag and drop, and they will train straight into my agent. And now you'll see up here, I've got 97 transcripts all trained in as text files. And what's more, I can also see how many times a video transcript was used in an AI agent reply. So now I just check add knowledge here for my AI agent, and I'm going to go through and select all of the transcripts that I've just uploaded into my AI agent's knowledge base. Okay, you'll see up here, it's importing the knowledge into my AI agent. Now that seems to be done, all that's left is to click enable. And now with two AI agents, one trained on my community and one trained on my YouTube videos, we can have a conversation with either. Going back to my inbox, look, AI Mike has just messaged me and I can ask him anything about my YouTube videos. Now this is really cool. I started by saying, tell me what you know. And it says I specialize in providing information and assistance related to the Creator Magic community, which is excellent. Tell me about Cursor. And immediately AI Mike knows it's an AI powered code editor. But also it says Mike Russell has demonstrated using Cursor for coding, but also creating content such as WordPress posts. So this is brilliant. Immediately my AI agent is pulling on knowledge from my YouTube videos and responding to the question that's asked. Okay, I'm throwing AI Mike a question. What tool should I use for voice cloning? AI Mike is having a think about that. And boom, look at that. Straight from the transcript of my videos for voice cloning, 11 Labs is a well-known service. That's absolutely what I would recommend. And AI Mike is bang on the money with that. And there you go. As you'll see in my AI agent analytics, messages are starting to come in and be recorded here. And what's more, I can go into this AI inbox over here and actually see the context of all the conversations that have happened with my AI agents. Now, this is great because I can see if everything is good. And if there's a point I need to step in, I can pause the AI using this button up here, and then I can actually hop in and chat. So while AI agents can automate a lot of my community management, I can still step in as the human as and where needed. Mike here from the future to show practically how these AI agents are working asked about Zapier. It not only gives info, but cites sources from the community. When challenged with a billing inquiry, no sweat for AI Mike to give details on how exactly to cancel the subscription. A good example here of human in the loop asked about which platform the community is built on. AI Mike didn't know because I've never spoken about it. So I stepped in, paused the AI, and said that the platform is Circle. And finally, when asked how to find a wife, AI Mike politely declined to answer, but when told he was amazing, he was very gracious in his reply. I think where this is going in the future is incredible and essentially allows us as independent creators, entrepreneurs, to scale our presence almost infinitely using all of the knowledge that we've created as humans. In the future, maybe we won't be required at all, but that's an existential crisis required for a different topic in a different video. I'm really excited about the new AI agents feature from Circle, and let me know how you get on with them in the comments down below. Oh, and by the way, YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.